Why is it that this ummah is dealing with this month in negligence? Why is it that we're not serious when this month comes? So yes, I agree with all of you, and I'm sure all of you know this, that this month is the month of mercy, the month of rahmah, the month of forgiveness. Rewards are multiplied. Allahu Akbar. But today, I have a slightly different message for all of you. This month, my brothers, yes, we agreed, it's the month of mercy, but forgive me for this statement that I will make, it can also be the month of wrath. It can also be the month of anger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It can also be the month that you will regret, everlasting regret. Why? Because our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is rahma lil alameen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah testified, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. O Prophet of Allah, you were sent as mercy for humanity. There's a very, very, very dangerous hadith. In this hadith, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, رَغِمَ أَنْفُ, may he be disgraced. What? Who's talking here? Who's speaking here? The Prophet of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who had mercy for his own enemies. He had mercy for the enemies of Islam, had mercy in his heart for the pillars of kufr, the pillars of animosity to this deen, he had mercy for them. Yet our Prophet in this hadith says, may he be disgraced. The Prophet of Allah is cursing someone. Have you ever been cursed in this world by a pious person? You know, sometimes your pious mother or your pious father or your pious sheikh that you know gets angry with you and says, you know what, like Allah, before he finishes, you jump, say, please stop. Mom, Allah yarda alayki, please don't say anything. Don't ghadab alayki, don't say anything, you know, please. Because you're afraid this person's dua is accepted. This person's supplication is accepted by Allah. Please don't say anything. Well, the Prophet of Allah says, may he be disgraced. May he be disgraced. May he be disgraced. Who, Prophet of Allah? قَالَ مَنْ أَدْرَكَ رَمَضَانَ. He who lives until Ramadan. ثُمَّ انْسَلَخْ وَلَمْ يُغْفَرْ لَهُ. May he be disgraced, this Muslim that lives until Ramadan, and yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not forgive him. In the other narration, إِذَا لَمْ يُغْفَرْ لَهُ فِيهِ فَمَتَى. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not forgive you in Ramadan, then when? When? When will Allah forgive you? If in this season of rahmah and mercy, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is accepting severe sinners, Allah is accepting them, forgiving their sins, raising their ranks, converting their bad deeds to good deeds. If Allah does not forgive you, then when will Allah forgive you? This is why, my brothers and sisters, I want you to understand. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the gates of mercy and opens the gates of rahmah for his slaves, but the slave insists on neglecting Allah, what is the result? Is the result mere loss of rewards? Does this person lose in reward? Like many of us think, wallah, if I don't go hard in Ramadan, I will just miss out on some reward. No, my brother and sister. If you do not act in this month, if you do not race in this month as is expected from you, the result can be the wrath of Allah. The result can be the curse of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam falling on you. So this month is the month of mercy. This race is the race of success. But not competing in this race or neglecting this race can also mean the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.